To successfully develop a C program, you need an editor for writing and modifying the source code, a compiler to translate your source code into object code or machine code, a linker to link together the object file that the compiler created with the object files that have been pre-compiled for you and collected into library files into an executable. Most of the integrated development environment or IDEs for C programming provide all these necessary tools. The IDE also directs the operating system's program called loader to load the executable file into computer's main memory or RAM so that the CPU can start processing the instructions. Furthermore, these IDEs also come with additional features like debugging, code completion, syntax highlighting, etc., thus maximizing the programmer's productivity. The thing which makes them most favored among the developers is their appealing user interface. The first C compiler I used was Borland Turbo C++ version 3.0 on a Windows XP PC 18 years back. Unfortunately, Turbo C++ 3.0 was a 16-bit compiler and does not support Windows 7 and above, so I had to switch eventually. Some of the top C++ IDEs in 2020 are CodeBlocks, NetBeans, Eclipse, CodeLite, Visual Studio, and Xcode for Mac. CodeBlocks, in my opinion, is one of the most lightweight and also very popular C++ IDE among the current alternatives. It's open source, cross-platform, and free. You can use this IDE on various platforms such as Windows, Mac, and Linux. So I recommend using it, and I will be using CodeBlocks throughout the entire course. You can download CodeBlocks from this link. From there, click Download the binary release. If you are a Windows user like me, download the setup file that contains mingw-setup.exe in its name. That includes both the IDE and the GCC compiler. If you are a Mac or Linux user, download CodeBlocks from the corresponding section. I am using a bit older version of CodeBlocks, version 17.12. If you want to use this version, just scroll down to the bottom and click the link for downloading older release versions. You can also install other IDEs on your computer to see which better suits your needs. However, as a beginner, you will find CodeBlocks to be easy to use and having all the features you need for C programming. Next, I will demonstrate how to write a simple Hello World program in C using CodeBlocks. See you there.